last episode we already created the following shape like this, the following particle. Okay, yep. And for the next step is trying to let all this particle flowing through these two blocks over here. The first step, we're gonna slow down like the particle flowing from the icon. So we're gonna put in a time test here. And to output this, if the first event to the second one, we'll just put in the cell now. Parameter over here, so we can link these two together. So this can is gonna make the particle flows and collect a certain amount of dots, and then flows down slower. And you can change the value and variation over here. Then we're gonna let all these particles coming out, finding the target over here, the first one, the first cylinder. So we're gonna use the find target parameter. Over here. This is gonna be our first event. And this find target, when you scroll down in this section, we can do pick and select the cylinder here. And then link these two together. So then over here you will see all this particle is now surrounding the cylinder, but we're gonna make all these particles stick on the cylinder. So next step, we're gonna put in physics collision and also pick the cylinder and change how into mesh. Besides, we're gonna change the display to geometry as well, so you can see the geometry that you have decided. Try to test again. If it's not working, you can try to add more frame on your animation over here. Let's see. Set end time as 150, and we're gonna change this default shading into a wireframe, so you can see the particles stick more clear. So you can see that all the particles is stick on it right now. Okay, I've changed it into 200 frame. So so you can see very clear. Like the particle is stick on it. So the next step is we're gonna repeat this find target. So we just copy this event. So the same. Change the display in the geometry, and the next target we're gonna set it as the rectangle. Yeah, and find the collision. Also, this rectangle using the mesh. And then connect and connect the event. So we'll see. Okay, with that, so this is all the event we need, like copy the same, exactly same step what it made for the first angle, and then connect the find target to the second time test event, and the result will be like this. And that's all of it. Thank you for watching.